Hi guys, today let's look into one of the core components of the automation framework, that is MAMIN. So as we had already seen in the previous presentation, previous videos, there are so many components in any automation framework, as GitHub, Jenkins, MAMIN, TestNG, etc. So MAMIN is one of the core components since it is used for building the automation framework. So this is a basic pictorial representation which gives a clear idea of what MAMIN does. So basically, through this you can see what form.xml file contains. Form.xml file contains it is a configuration file basically that is used for configuring various settings of the project. So we can see over here we have in the configuration file the build phases, that is the goals that needs to be executed. The goals are nothing but the tasks that we wanted to perform, and the dependencies that need to be configured for our project, which will be downloaded from the central repository and placed in the local MAMIN local repository, the build plugins that are used for executing, and the build profile. Build profiles are nothing but if we wanted to segregate our environments, our configurations based on the environments. Assume developer environment has a different configuration, testing environment has a different configuration, production environment has a different configuration. These are managed by the build profiles. Build profiles for different environments will be having a separate build profile. So the based on the build profile, configuration varies. For example, there is no requirement for the test plugin, the SUFR plugin in development environment. That's only required in testing environment where the automation framework exists. Automation scripts will be executed. So there is no requirement for the plugin in the development environment. So we'll not be configuring. We'll be configuring in such a way that the particular plugin will not be available for development environment. So that's how some of the it's a basic idea of how build profiles are used for managing the configuration settings of the profile. So here are the basic steps that the MAMIN does. First, MAMIN reads the form.xml file. This is the configuration file for setting up the project and building our project. And then it downloads the dependencies from the central repository to the MAMIN local repository. And then it starts executing the lifecycle methods, the phases, the goals that are configured as a part of the build profile. And then it starts executing based on the plugins available. So these are all things then based on the build profile that is selected. So this is a basic overview of the MAMIN introduction. Let's see what are the concepts that we are going to cover as a part of this discussion. So basically we are going to see a brief introduction of build tools, and then starting with the MAMIN project structure, and then followed by what is the MAMIN tool and what it does, and what's the archetype in MAMIN, what is the artifact and group ID in MAMIN, what are the naming conventions to be followed, and then we'll fall back to the MAMIN profile as we have discussed already. Basic build profiles, and then we'll be looking at the form.xml file and the role of it in MAMIN. What's the purpose of it in MAMIN? What's the purpose or the importance of it in automation, any automation framework? And then we'll be looking at the MAMIN dependencies, how to download the dependencies, and how to get the artifact ID and the group ID for the MAMIN dependencies, for configuring the MAMIN dependencies. And then we'll be looking into MAMIN plugins. What are the various plugins available? Why are these useful for? And what does MAMIN SUFR plugin use for? And compiler plugin use for? Failsafe plugin use for? We'll be looking into various plugins available. And then we'll fall back to the MAMIN lifecycle. What are the basic lifecycle? What are the three basic lifecycles that are available as a part of the build lifecycle? And then what is the MAMIN goal? How it is related to build lifecycle? And then we'll be looking at the repository types that are available in MAMIN. And then we'll be creating a simple MAMIN project. And then a quick recap, I'll give over you using the quick reference that are available in the MAMIN site. So these are the basic topics that we are going to cover as a part of MAMIN build automation tool. Thanks guys, in the next video we'll start the basic introduction and overview of all the things one after the other.